Hi, good morning everyone. This is our third video on asana. In it, we are going to see four asanas. The first one, Trikonasana. Second one, Ekapadasana. Third one, Garudasana. Fourth one, Savasana. Let's begin our session with prayer.
Om Sahana Bhavatu Sahano Bhunaktu Sahavivyam Karavavahai Tejasvinavati Tamastu Mavit Vishavahai Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
The first asana is Trikonasana, which is known as triangle pose. Trikonasana is the combination of two Sanskrit words, trikon and asana, where trikon means triangle and asana means pose. This asana looks like the triangle shape. That's the reason this asana is also known as Trikonasana. In the asana, the body is stretched in such a way the triangle like shape is formed. Now, let's see the benefits of Trikonasana. Trikonasana, it stretches and strengthens the thighs, knees and ankles. It stretches the hips, groins and calves. It stimulates the abdominal hormones, relieves back aches, improves digestion, helps relieve stress. Stand erect. Yeah, keep distance between your legs about 3 to 4 feet. Extend your arms at the shoulder level. Breathe in and raise your right arm by the side of your head. Yeah, slowly go down and place your right palm on your right ankle. Slowly turn your upper body and see your left arm tip. Yeah, slowly relax. Come to starting position. Relax. Do the same procedure with the left arm. Ekapadasana, which is known as one foot pose. Ekapadasana is a pose in which one needs to perform the asana standing on one foot. It is very difficult to balance the whole body on one foot. It can be achieved by constant practice. This shows that Ekapadasana is all about balancing. This asana teaches us to balance our body and mind. Yeah, in this slide, we see the benefits of Ekapadasana. Ekapadasana, it strengthens the arms, wrist, back, hips and leg muscles. It improves muscle coordination, balance and concentration. This asana shapes and tones the legs. It strengthens the ankle joints. It relaxes the lower back. Stand up straight with the legs slightly apart. Now raise your right leg. Unfold to place your right heel on left inner thigh. Join your palms in front of chest and raise over the head. Maintain this pose as long as you can. Regulate normal breath. Yeah, slowly relax to move starting position. Garudasana, which is also known as eagle pose. Yeah, seated eagle pose or seated Garudasana opens up the joints and shoulders. In Sanskrit, Garuda is the name of eagle, which is vehicle of Lord Vishnu. Asana means pose. In the seated eagle pose, the two arms are brought together and the forearms are twisted together. Let's see the benefits of Garudasana. Seated eagle pose stretches the joints of wrist, elbows and shoulders. It improves the posture of the upper trunk. It straightens the spine and makes it steady. It opens up the shoulders and chest, removes stress from the shoulders and the lower neck region. Sit in a comfortable position on the floor. Fold right leg and keep it below the left leg. Now fold left leg, keep on right leg. Bring the two hands together with elbows close each other. At this point, the two arms are entwined together like two snakes. Keep the spine straight. Breathe normally in this position. Once again, I will show you the arm position. Breathe normally in this position. Slowly relax to move starting position. Now, Savasana, which is also known as death or corpse pose. Savasana is a practice of gradually relaxing one body part at a time, one muscle at a time, and one thought at a time. When you do this practice day after day, it conditions the body to release stress and can improve your sense of physical and emotional well-being. Savasana is a Sanskrit name. Sava means corpse or death. Asana means pose. Let's see the benefits of Savasana. It calms central nervous system, aiding the digestive and immune systems. It calms the mind and reduce stress. It reduces headache, fatigue, and anxiety. It helps to lower blood pressure. It promotes spiritual awakening and awareness of higher consciousness. Let's practice the asana. Lie down on your back with the support of your elbow. Relax your body. Point your toes outward and relax your arms, palm facing upward. Slowly close your eyes. Breathe normally. Now concentrate on your breath. Slowly relax and open your eyes. Slightly turn and come to starting position. Thank you. Let's finish our session with closing prayer.
Asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityorma amritam gamaya sarvesham swastir bhavatu sarvesham shantir bhavatu Sarvesham Purnam Bhavatu Sarvesham Mangalam Bhavatu Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Om.